Good afternoon, students. My name is Arinda Herman. I will give you a presentation on the April exam for music and drama. So let us just get started. I'm talking about musical elements. Now this is a very, very important question in the exams. So make already sure that you put NB next to it because I will definitely ask for it. Let us start with the first one. The first one is about pulse. What does pulse mean? That is the underlying throb in music which may be felt throughout any music with a strong beat or a march. Now let me explain to you what a strong beat is. A strong beat is when you, like you hear the church bell, it will make dong, eh? Yes, a strong beat. And then you get wooden blocks that will just make a light sound, tang tang tang, something like that. That is what we are talking about, the pulse. Now duration is concerned with the length of a music, whether it is long or short. In the duration, it says, for example, That the sound can be long. When you hear something like this, like dong, can you hear the sound is long? And a short sound like tang tang, then the short is softer, and it's also lighter. Then we get to tempo. Now tempo refers to the speed or the pace of music. Now you must be careful. A lot of you are writing speeding. Now speeding we get when we are doing traffic rules. Now speeding is something different to the speed of music. Now when we get to the speed of music, sometimes when you listen to the music, because they always use music in the background when they have a movie, then you can, in the music, you must listen carefully. So don't look at the, just close your eyes for a moment and listen to the background music. If the music is fast, then you know something, it's going to explain something about fear. And if the music is soft or it's calm, then it will explain something very soft that will happen. But sometimes when the music is fast, then it can also explain fear or excitement. Now there are 9 of them. Make sure that you know all of them. And the last one that I want you to concentrate on is style. Now when we explain style, then you need to mention all the different elements when you do style. For example, you must talk about the timbre, the texture, the tempo, the dynamics, the pitch, the pulse or the duration, and the structure. So you must mention all of them when you do style. You cannot just say style is the application of all musical elements. No, you must mention all of them by name. So I hope you understand what that was all about. It's a very important thing. You will use it when you go out for practice teaching next year. You will use these elements in pre-primary, grade 1 and grade 2. So be aware that you know them. It is very important. The next one is gross and fine motor skills. Now let us just break it up. Gross is a German word that means big. Fine is an English word that means small. So I hope you wrote that down. Because if you understand what the word means, then you will understand it easily. I explain again. Gross is a German word that means big. That means the big muscles. And fine is an English word that means small muscles. So let us start now. Gross motor skills. So in childhood, the gross motor skills is the first set of skills your child need to master. For example, it's all the big muscles like the arms and the legs that they must use. For example, when they are sitting, if they can't sit, if their muscles are not developed like the arms and the legs, they won't be able to sit properly and they won't be able to do their work. Then it's the legs and the feet that is, it helps them with running, for example, with the big motor skills. Then also rolling. When children like to roll when they are on the grass, they like to roll from left to right on the grass using their whole body. But they can also roll a ball when they bend their legs and they use their arms. They can also roll a ball, and they can also roll down a hill. That is when they also use the gross motor skills. Now let us go to the fine motor skills. Remember when you explain anything in music and drama, for example, the gross motor skills, you must give your own examples. Don't always look in the book for an example. You must just think of what kind of example. Especially when I look at my children in the class, or I look at my daughter at home when she's just playing outside. What is she using her arms for? What is she using her legs for? So you must always look at children. What are they doing? Don't always think, oh, it's just the examples in the book that I need to use. No, you can use your own example. Now we get to fine motor skills. Fine motor skills entails using your small muscles of your body. For example, in writing, they use their eyes and they use their hands or their fingers. Then coordinating hand-eye movement. Now hand-eye movement is when you use your eyes and when you use your hand, like I just said now, when they do painting or they do writing or they do anything, or they even when they are putting beads in on a string, that is also using hand-eye movement. Then creating works of art and moving your eyes or your lips, because everything has to do with small muscles. So these are examples of fine motor skills. Also, when you pick up a leaf, you pick it up with your fingers, your two fingers. You will not use your whole hand to pick up a small leaf. Okay, so let's go on. Now, uses of music in advertising. Why do people use music in advertising? You can just imagine, if there's an advert where a person is just talking, you will get bored very soon. So that is why they use music in adverts, and they will also use music in movies, because it creates a better background. And also music is something that we also remember for a very long time, even if you can't remember the advert, but the music is striking, it has a nice beat and so on, then you will remember the ad. So let's go to the first one. The first one says it is used for entertainment. Do I need to say more? You know what entertainment is. Everybody likes to be entertained. Now, music conveys a message. So when the ad is on, if the advertisement is on the TV, for example, it's a Coke advert, and it has a nice background music, then you will be entertained. You will listen to the music. Every time the ad comes up, you will also sing along, and you will be entertained. That is what entertainment is all about. Now, the second one says structure. Now, let me just say more about structure, that you can have a better idea what structure is all about. Structure says, or structure or continuity means music, the music, to use the music efficiently, it contributes to the ad story in a matter of 30 seconds. Because the ad is very short, because people are paying for that. So this advertisement must have a story. What does the people want you to listen to? What does the people want you to buy? So you must listen. In the ad, there will be a story. And that is what structure is. And then the third one is, it says memorability. That means for how long will you remember? After you hear the ad and you listen to the music, will you really remember the ad? If you can remember the ad, like in Coke, if they make an advertisement about Coke, if you can remember it, that is already a memorable advertisement, because it will linger for a long time in your mouth, in your mind. You will even sing the song also when you are driving your car or just doing your work. And then the next one is, it's a lyrical language. Music conveys a message. That means the music must convey a message in a non-spoken way. Now, when we say non-spoken way, that means we will not use words, but while the people are doing the ad or doing something without talking, the music will tell you, it will tell you a little story. That is why I said it conveys a message. And then the next one is authority establishment. That means the music gives a genuine appeal to its target audience. If you have an advert that focuses on the youth, for example, you want to teach them something in the advertisement, like for example, be careful of going out, or be careful, especially when I think now of MVA, they always make an ad that says, oh, they have a car that is very fast and a high speed, on a high speed, but there's no words in there. That is a word without, that is a message that is conveyed without words. So that it's just the actions, but there's no words, but you will remember it because of the action that you see and also the music that you hear. So this is a very important one. Make sure that you know them. Let me just go through them again. So when we use music in advertising for entertainment, number one, for structure, that is mean when you do a story. We use it for memorability, so that you can remember the thing for a very long time in your mind. And then lyrical language, that means it must convey a message without words. And the next one is targeting. Targeting just means, which kind of audience do you target? Are you targeting young people, children? Are you targeting youthful people? Or are you targeting older people? And then authority establishes. That means there is already a target group, ne? A genuine appeal to its target group. And yeah. So make sure that you also know this one. And you can also give your own examples, like examples from Coke. You must just look at different ads that you can have ideas of what you can use. But keep your book with you. So when you listen to an ad and you can remember, then you just write it. Oh, it sticks in my mind. Oh, it is memorable. So that is what it is all about. So the next one says speech and development. Now, because speech and development is such a long question, and it also counts for a lot of marks, and you must know it, please. Let me go step by step, because I broke it up in three parts. I said, first I start with the introduction. That means singing, playing, singing games. The next one is tapping out the rhythm. For example, if I do this, that is stepping out the rhythm. Then listening is means the direction of reading. Now, when we do direction of reading, we will usually do it in grade one. Not the singing and playing, we will own, and singing games we will do in pre-primary, but listening when we do direction of reading, we will do in grade 1. So when you go out next year, you must also check, are you going to pre-primary, are you going to grade 1? Then you will see the difference there. Because in pre-primary, they will sing a lot of times, but in grade 1, it's more about learning sounds and phonics and things like that. So when the what I mean by direction of reading is, you can take a torch if you want to test the eye movement. Ne? Then you take a torch, you switch off all the lights in the class, you take the torch and you take the torch from left to right slowly, and you say, and you tell them, don't move your head, just move your eyes, so that you can see, are they moving their eyes from left to right? And then you can also let the torch go from up and down, so that you can see if they can move their eyes. Because when we read, eye movement is very important. So make NB next to this question. That was the introduction. Now we get to speech development. Now speech development, there are three things in speech development. It's talking about vocal sounds, breathing, and songs. Let me start with the first one. Sorry. When we talk about vocal sounds, we talk about singing and nursery rhymes. Now, a nursery rhyme is something like, hey, diddle, diddle, the cat and the fiddle. You must just listen to the nursery rhymes that the children are coming home with. So, in a nursery rhyme, there's also a rhythm. Ne? You don't say, hey, diddle, diddle. No, you say, hey, diddle, diddle. So, it's also like singing the nursery rhyme. That is what we talk about, vocal sounds. Then we talk about breathing. Now, when they... You must teach them how to breathe when they sing, so that they can control their breathing. Because they cannot just sing la 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 la. No, you will tell them, I will even fall asleep if you sing like this. So you must teach them, you must breathe in and out. And in and out. Now we are going to sing something, so that you can see how you will breathe in and breathe out. When they sing, for example, today is the day. Can you see the breathing there? Today, and they breathe in, is the day. Every time they must breathe before they can sing. That is why I said they must control their breathing. Now, at the third one, it says songs. Now with songs, we get different things. We get action, and we can also use our body parts. For example, if I sing, head, shoulders, knees, and toes. Can you see? So they will touch their body parts, and they will also sing. And when they touch their body parts, they will do the actions. So that the actions in the song can lead them to the body parts, and they can remember it longer. So can you see, I don't use the same song every time. And the songs that I know, maybe you don't know it, but you know other songs. So that is why I said, use your own example. Okay, the next one is language development. Now here you must listen carefully, because language development is not like speech development. What speech is more about what you say. What language you will listen, you need to listen what your ears, what you say, so what you say and what you hear has to do with language. And that is also how a baby, because the baby is listening to you a lot, like you will always say, come here, come to mommy, and later on the child will also say mommy or mama. Can you see? It's the language that must be developed. Now let us start with the first one. The first one says describing sounds, and then it says you must hear which sounds are outside, and you must listen to the sounds that are inside. Now this is more for pre-primary and grade 1. It's not for kindergarten children. So this is listening, and it's also preparing them. Because if they can't If they just talk all the time but they don't listen, they can later on not remember what they heard. So when we say describing sounds, you must listen. You tell them, close your eyes in the class, sit on the carpet, close your eyes. What do you hear outside? Then you tell them, don't scream out. You must tell me what you heard outside. Then the one will say, oh, I heard people talking. I can hear a bird. I can hear a car passing by. So everybody must listen to for something else. Then you say, okay, now close your eyes again. What do you hear on the inside of the class? Maybe somebody is coming in, a visitor is coming in, then they will hear footsteps, or they will hear the wind, or they will hear somebody walking in the class. So those are sounds that they hear outside and inside that will describe the sounds. Now the next one is new words. What do we mean by new words? Now with new words, it says sound, the sound of words and phonics. Now there's a big difference between the two. I hope you have your pencil and your pen ready and your book. Because if we say, we talk about phonics in grade one, that means the sounds. If I say the word pot, then I want, because they will just hear one word, then you must ask them, listen again, pot. Which word, which sound did you hear first? And they will say, I heard a p. Which sound did you hear last? Then some of them maybe didn't catch it. Then you must repeat the word and you say, pot. Now you put emphasis on the last sound. So you ask again, what sound did you hear last? Oh, ma'am, I heard a t sound. So that is what phonics is all about, ne? Breaking up the word so that they can hear the word has three sounds, like a p, a o, and a t. So you must make sure that is why I said their ears, their hearing must be very well developed before they can put sounds together to form words. Number three says feelings and senses. Yeah, feelings and senses. With feelings and senses, it has to do with the emotions. So how do you feel when you hear or you listen to a different song? That is what feelings mean. And the last one is songs. Songs that will help them to relax when they learn. Especially when they were doing mathematics and a lot of things that they and use their mind. You must also always put soft music on so that they can also relax at the end. And that is the end of my presentation. So, and please do not call me when you are writing exams. You better go through your things today already so that you can see this I don't understand. Oh, this I didn't understand it very well. Then you phone me. If the phone ring for more than three times, then please send me a SMS so that when I have time, then I can reply, even if it's later. And then the other thing is, don't call me when I'm at school between 7 and 1. You cannot call me. That is why I said the contact time to call me is after school, is between 2 o'clock and 5 o'clock. So please, we want you to do well in your exams. We want you to be confident. So please, from today onwards, even if you don't study, just go through your work. If you don't understand something, go to an experienced teacher to ask what you don't understand. And sometimes also go to a school just to get an idea of what people are doing in practice, because it's very important. And the other thing is the more you see, the more you will remember. Thank you so much.